One of the biggest shadows of the wrap industry is just the massive amount of waste that just builds up after even after a day of install. All the vinyl and the backing paper gets thrown in together along with other recyclables, and it gets thrown in the dumpster out back, which obviously leads to high cost for a wrap shop and is terrible for the landfill. At the end of the day, these can be separated. This is just an example of the waste that was after a two-day workshop that I taught. And separating does take a massive amount of time. Obviously, sometimes drinks and food get thrown in there, so it gets really messy and nasty. And even some microfiber towels actually gonna get thrown away, some high cost there. And after separating, it does lead to a lot less waste. So in this case, it was four less trash bins as opposed to eight, which is cool, that's nice, but I think that could be nipped in the bud by getting just a better workflow in the space. One of the easiest ways to do that is what's called a central lay flat liner pile. I'm really big into this, so right now I'm at Car Up City. These guys are banging out a lot of installs right now, so basically what they're doing right now is just taking all the backing paper and laying it flat centrally in the space. Just make it part of your routine, just super simple. And if it becomes part of the routine, it doesn't take up hardly any extra time at all. And very, very important to make sure that that liner pile lays extra flat. Don't fold the paper because it keeps it from folding up nice and tight. And the goal at the end of the day is to have one roll at the end of the day, and it just goes right in a trash can. And you can see how barely it fits that trash can. So you could easily get five in there. So a 5-day work week with one trash bin. This is the exact same liner pile. I took it back up and unrolled it, and now I'm just jamming it in the trash bins, and that instead of having it just barely fit in one, now it's just jam-packed into two. And this is, again, very common for most wrap shops, is throwing that liner right in those trash cans. And what happens now is install workflow gets totally stopped, because now, you know, obviously you can't throw the trash in there anymore, and you don't want your workspace looking terrible. So now you have to go out back and you have to pick this up, and oftentimes those trash bins are really nasty and they smell terrible. So, and once they start getting really full, because they're obviously going to get super full of doing it this way, it'd be very dirty and frustrating for the installers. Now they have to come, you know, clean themselves again. And this again just stops workflow. So the ideal TWI green equals green setup is having a recycle bin, both for plastic and for paper, and the vinyl only goes in the trash bins itself. And then the paper lays flat, nice and easy and straightforward, super easy setup. If you're, let's say you're on location, you can do the exact same kind of logic, but now you're basically just putting the backing paper under the vehicle per se in this case. And then once the vehicle is done, it could be rolled out, all the backing paper is underneath. And this just makes it very easy for the installer to roll up and just again have that one roll pile up at the end of the day. Same production can do actually the exact same thing. So for production workflow, production is doing a slightly different trash as opposed to installers, but the same logic can be used. In this case, having a recycle bin, and again, this is reusable. Again, having one for paper, nice and easy, light to pick up throughout the production area. And what's different about production versus install, for example, here is instead of having like big sheets for the most part, you're having these small strips, but even these small strips should be laid flat. You think they don't take up too much space in the trash bin, but they do. So now instead of having two trash bins now, the lay flat pile goes in one and then everything else is getting recycled. Nice, easy, and straightforward. And a good tip for either, you know, install or production is don't use trash bags. Don't need them in this case. And with this whole setup now, you can have these reusable bags, don't need trash bins, and then obviously make sure that the trash bin itself has wheels, so just it's really easy to wheel around your shop. So again, there's no excuse not to have this in position when you're doing workflow. So once you get this set up right here, all the trash and the recycle goes where it needs to go. And so for the wrap up right now, extremely important to have that lay flat liner pile. Just change your logic and don't put that backing paper in the trash. Put it on the floor in one central spot, because you have to think big picture. If you do this, it definitely saves a huge amount of time within your workspace, will cut your waste by at least 40 to 60%, if not more. And this obviously just means to higher profits, because you're gonna have a smaller waste bill at the end of the year, but you're also gonna have more focused workflow. And more importantly, it really does keep your shop incrementally cleaner. So it's gonna lead to a more professional workspace, which is the name of the game. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thanks for watching, Justin Payne.